There was nothing unusual about the $14,492 in charges thieves put on my credit card in 48 hours at discount supermarkets and gas stations in Hamilton. 5 visits to Price Choppers in 2 days. $1,209.75 at the same store in 1 day. Have you ever tried to spend that much at Price Chopper? They don't sell tobacco. You gotta put a lot of Kraft dinner in the cart to get to $1,200. No, my credit card company pulled the plug after my wife bought a $4.75 latte. They thought that was unusual. Normally, I check my statement online every 48 hours to curtail purchases as much as to look for fraud. Doesn't it seem like everyone you know has had their credit card compromised at some time? But Visa Canada said the $407 million in annual fraudulent activity only accounts for 0.1% of all activity. For consumers, the size of a fraud isn't too big of a deal because in most cases, the credit card companies will reimburse you. I got my reversal in less than a week. The issue is inconvenience. No credit card for 48 hours. And then there are all those automatic charges to your account. I have about 10 companies to contact to give them my new number. At one point, consumers used to be on the hook for frauds. Then it switched to paying a small deductible. But the sophistication of the attacks reached a point where the credit card companies had to take on the liability or lose customers. Since my wife and I both still had our cards on us, we were likely the victims of card skimming, a widespread practice where information on the magnetic strip on the back of your card is copied at a tampered with terminal. Often the retailer has no knowledge it is going on. But I question how much retailers are doing at the point of sale, especially in my case. One of the corner gas station kiosks put through a charge for $650. That was likely cigarettes, according to the fraud division of my credit card company. If someone's asking you for 10 or so cartons of smokes, you should call the cops, or at least the Lung Association. Retailers are supposed to follow procedures like checking the signatures. But since they have no liability on a fraudulent credit card transaction, they got no reason to raise a red flag. You want to know the worst part of all this? I don't even get to keep the nearly 15,000 in reward points the thieves racked up. My credit card company will be taking those back. Until the credit card companies can figure out a way to stop these thieves, our lives will be marred by fraudsters.